getting right into the dirty details of where we're at right now on my 62 Corvair Rampside pickup mid-engine LS swap. Obviously, we got the steering column in, steering wheel mounted. We're going to go through all the details of that to figure out how we got the steering to work on this with a reverse one-to-one box out of a Nissan Pathfinder. We've got a steering rack out of a Nissan Skyline. Everything fit with the Corvette suspension up front. We've got the air ride system mounted. These upper steering column mounts are actually connecting rods from my buddy's alcohol funny car. I'll tell you about that later. The pedal assemblies, we've got a stock GM drive-by wire pedal assembly. We've also got a Wilwood brake pedal assembly that has the master cylinder built right into it. We've got a line lock installed. All the brakes are hooked up, ready to bleed. The exhaust is done. That was a chore in and of itself. We ceramic coated that. I've got it all installed. Gonna be doing the engine harness and the fuel system here shortly. Probably the highlight of the interior, which will remain one of my favorite pieces of the interior, is the steering wheel that we have from Big Ron's Wheels on Instagram. Check them out. This is an I Did It steering column. Here's the upper column mounts. Those are forged rods from my buddy's alcohol funny car. I'm gonna pan over to that right now. You can see that Camaro funny car there. I used to pit crew on that car back in the early 2000s, I believe it was. This is where I'm gonna be running the ignition key. This is where I'm gonna be running the line lock. Here's the very rough cut bench seat frame that we're gonna be using. I still have to make some hinges and mounts for the lower piece, but that is what we're gonna have to do in here. You can see how we've had to radius that around the tubs on both sides to get us the most we can as far as width goes out of this thing. Here's a look at the Nissan upper steering control box. This is out of a Nissan Pathfinder. This is a 1-to-1 ratio, and it reverses the input to output. This is the output of that Pathfinder upper control box. Comes into our steering shaft here. Now, if you remember from the last video, this steering shaft is actually the steering column shaft out of this Corvair, because this spline on this end right here, this spline matched the Nissan U-joint here for this steering rack out of a Nissan Skyline. This is out of a right-hand drive Nissan Skyline. Fortunately for me, these stock 14 mil tie rod ends for Corvette threaded right on to the Nissan Skyline rack. No modification needed. Here we've got one of the wheel height sensors mounted for the AccuAir air ride. There's the two lines for the power steering rack. We had to relief cut the original subframe up front here just to clearance that so we could get those 90 degree fittings in there. Here's some of the brake lines for the front. Up here, and hang on with me here, where they go right up into the floor and up to the master cylinder. Well, you've seen the upper side of the fuel tank. Right here is the pavement view of what's gonna happen here if I come across something that's a little high. Hopefully it just hits this skid plate and skims right out the back without denting or damaging my fuel tank. That fuel tank does hang about 3 inches lower than the cross member up front here for the suspension. So it is the lowest point on the truck right now. That's why we built this skid plate. This is probably one of the few vehicles out there that has 6 tubs on it to make clearance for the wheels. Both of the doors had to be clearanced. The windows still roll down the way they should, just so we could clear the tubs that are here for when this thing is at full drop. Now, there is still about 25% turning radius, the way we've had the wheel offset and the clearance up underneath there. I searched high and low for long tube headers for this thing. Couldn't find anything that would work. The way this box is designed is in the back here, it's higher and it drops down to a lower portion up front. I could not find a set of long tube headers that would work for this. So lucky my buddy Lloyd is a genius when it comes to fabrication. He was able to build this exhaust from scratch. Let's have a closer look at it.
There's the X pipe, or we've aptly named it the sex pipe. Here's the headers. These are all about 31 inches long into that collector. Check out that collector. I don't know if anybody's ever done a curved collector like that before. There's really no bad angles of this exhaust. Lloyd has just done an exceptional job. You can see the copper lines we used for coolant. Come all the way to the back, go into either side of the radiator. Still have to mount the electric fans under that and build the shroud that comes from here across so it draws its fresh air in from the vents on the original location. Got the fuel pump mounted. Just need to run some lines from the back of the fuel tank here. Pretty sure this cap from Crafty B off Instagram is gonna make this thing go faster. He handcrafts these, does all the sand casting himself. All the polishing, just ridiculous craftsmanship. Finally got the tailgate off and fixed, primed with a red oxide primer. I'm going to be patina painting that to kind of match the sides and the rest of the paint on this. I think in the end, instead of using clear coat, I'm going to do what other guys have used that I've seen a couple vehicles now. They've just used linseed oil to coat everything. I did polish a spot right here just quickly to try and get the kind of white gunk off of there, the oxidizing. I don't like that it shined it up, but we'll see what we can do about that. Today I've got to finish tightening up all the exhaust clamps and bands. That's why when I was filming the exhaust, you could see some shop towels and paper towels underneath stuff just to make the clearance in the right spot for when I do tighten it up. I'm going to install the starter today. I've got the engine harness here, going to install that. I got to go grab some exhaust bung plugs because we've got two spots on the header here, one for when we tune it and the other for the O2 sensors. So I gotta grab some O2 sensors and some stainless exhaust bungs. This intake here, we've got a couple ideas. We're just in the process of doing some fabbing to figure out what looks best. We've got some aluminum mesh that has some really fine holes in it. We're gonna make our own coil covers instead of just buying what's available off the shelf. Number one, if I'm gonna spend $500 or $600 on something, I think I'd rather just spend that money and build it ourselves. So we're gonna make our own custom coil covers for this, probably bring it down and get everything nice and tight to the top of the headers here. This Corvette differential has 2 7-3 gears in it. So probably a little tall for what I want, but until I drive this and actually do some testing and tuning, there's no sense changing it and not being happy with just what I think is gonna work. These are the CV shafts I had made by the drive shaft shop. You can find them on Instagram as well.
These are rated for up to 600 horsepower, and the CVs are a Porsche style CV. Man, they do nice work. So you gotta find the secret combination to get this starter in here with the copper cooling lines, and wouldn't you know it, luck would have it that it just snakes right up in there like nobody's business. Now if I can get a bolt in before I drop it on my lips, that'd be great.
Bust a left, a right, I'm out of sight, I'm throwed, I'm bouncing off the road to me.